In this video, I'm going to go over some annoying things in Google Sheets, no matter which level of user you are. So the ones that I'm going to choose in this video are not going to be geared towards like advanced users only. It's going to be just across the board. So the first one I'm going to go over is going to be double click when you drag formulas down. So for example, if I create a formula over here to take the city and concatenate it with, let's say, a comma and a space with another and sign with the state. So as you can see, it will suggest you to autofill this. But for this, I'm not going to do that, even though it doesn't matter. I'm going to X out of this. So generally, when you're trying to drag this formula down, you could just do that by just double clicking in this little box. And that goes all the way. Now let's say you've decided to change this formula. So you go back in here and let's say we don't want a comma anymore. We decided to add a dash like this. So I'm going to change that formula. Now I want to drag that formula down again to the bottom. So I'm going to double click here too. And as you can see, it no longer works until you erase all of these formulas below and then you can double click. And it's been like this for a long time. I'm not sure if this is ever going to be changed. So the next one, let's actually delete this, is going to be the design of filters. So for example, if I have this data and I want to filter this data, I'll go under data and do create a filter. That's going to add a filter. And now we can just open this and add a filter. Now, they work as they should. It filters things out. But it's not very intuitive the way this thing works, especially when you start having a lot of different options, a lot of data. So let's actually move to this data for a second and add a filter to this. Now, let's say we're trying to work with just Adidas products. So I'm going to open this. Now, because there's a lot, you would probably just go here and start searching Adidas in this box. Kind of shows the options here. So if I press OK now, that doesn't filter to Adidas, right? So if I go back and do Adidas again and, you know, uncheck, check, I don't know, whatever you do, it doesn't work. So it absolutely makes no sense the way this thing works. We would have to do filter by condition, switch this to something like text contains, type Adidas, press OK. And that was just one example. It's just not intuitive. And it's not just based on my personal experience. I do a lot of classes and I get a lot of people who are new to spreadsheets who are introduced to these functionalities. And I can tell you, I've never seen a new user that was comfortable with these filters. So number three, let's add a bunch of sheets here, is going to be the fact that it's impossible to delete multiple worksheets at a time without at least using some sort of script. So if I go here, there's no way to do like shift or command or something to select multiple to delete this worksheet. You would have to go one by one and delete each worksheet. Let's go back to our data. So the number four is going to be the fact that there is no way to conditionally format duplicates without using formulas. So you couldn't just go here, select this column of data and just go under format and do conditional formatting and just choose something like duplicates to just highlight those. Now I understand I can do this with a formula, right? So I can go under custom formula is and then do equals count if and then do something like E colon E comma and then E2. E2 being the cell that I'm currently in, right in here, and then simply just check, is this greater than one? And you can see that Crocs is not highlighted now because there is not another one in this column. All these other values will repeat at least once. So if I had done here, see if I clear this Adidas to Adidas 2 or something, this is not highlighted anymore. This is still highlighted because there's another Adidas here someplace. See, there it is. So if I change this to Adidas 3, see, that will lose the color and this will lose the color. So again, you can do it with a formula, but you shouldn't have to. So that's my number four. And my number five is, again, related to conditional formatting. And it is the fact that if you decide to apply conditional formatting, so let's say I do greater than 100, right? Or something like that. There is no way to add borders. So you can do background colors. You can do font colors. You can do like underlines, you can make it bold, whatever, but you cannot add a border to the cell. So these are things that have been like this for a long time. Now we're in 2021, we still have to deal with all of these things. So I'll probably make another video for people who are more intermediate advanced levels. But for this one, let me know if I did miss something. I probably did.